excited about this interview. It's the 30th anniversary of the Emmanuel and Helen Olshan Texas Music Festival Orchestra Series, and it's getting underway this weekend here in Houston. And our guests today are not just taking part in it. They truly know how to bring music to our ears. At 23 years old, this one right here, Kyle Rivera, is doing something very special with the festival and the Houston Symphony. And Rivera is here along with the General Artistic Director for the festival, Alan Austin, and they're here to share some amazing news. First of all, thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
I am beyond excited about 30 years.
30 years
is
incredible.
This is a long time. This is truly incredible. And now you're involved for so many different reasons. But first and foremost, what is it like for you to be involved in music? Because you play the viola. You're like a triple threat. You have a degree. You're getting a degree in kinesiology and composing and all of that. Tell me about it.
Yeah, it's really kind of amazing, like, to have so much in my life that I really am passionate about and can kind of move towards and then work hard for. Mm-hmm. I've learned so much in my time at U of H about, like, the music world and just about how to reach people and find a new way to be expressive, because I have, like you said, kinesiology and music and composition. And so I have so many ways that I can, you know, reach out and help people with their bodies, help them learn how to feel good physically and learn how to feel good emotionally. So there's really a lot that is really rewarding.
I love that. And also, speaking of this festival, you have been involved in this festival since almost the beginning, because you actually competed in the festival.
Actually, the very beginning, yes. I was a student in 1990 in the very first program. And a few years later, I started doing small jobs around the festival and then gradually worked my way up.
And now, and as director, when it comes to this program, how many students are actually involved and participate in this?
Well, we have an orchestra of about 95 of classical music's best young students who come from all over the world. We also have right now going on an opera program for young singers. We have programs for jazz, for high school jazz mm-hmm. musicians. We also have a program for flute players. So there's
that.
A lot going on, and we put on over 30 concerts in the month of June.
And during June also, people can participate and come to these performances. And one in particular with this one, he's making his television debut here, but you actually compose and you compose something the Houston Symphony is going to be performing during this festival. Hello.
That
doesn't happen every year. And you're not only a Katrina survivor, but you're doing this now. And how does that make you feel?
It's kind of overwhelming sometimes. I wake up and I don't remember that I'm in this position. It's like I just remember myself always working hard and always, you know, having these dreams and goals, but then, you know, to kind of be here now, it still doesn't feel totally real.
I know. Now you're going to be performing for us, but quickly, what is the website where people can get information?
TMF, like Texas Music Festival, at uh.edu.
Mm-hmm. People can come out, participate. You've got to go to this all month long, but like I said, he's making his television debut right here on CW39 Morning Dose right after this break, so don't go anywhere. We're going to hear from Kyle with his viola. You're going to be so excited. I'm excited. We'll be right back.